Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and Apple released iOS 16.2 Developer Beta 3 today. And iOS 16.2 Public Beta 3 is going to be out either by the time you're watching this video or usually the next day. Now this released alongside watchOS 9.2 Beta 3, iPadOS 16.2 Beta 3, macOS 13.1 Beta 3, tvOS 16.2 Beta 3, and audioOS 16.2 Beta 3, or HomePodOS 16.2 Beta 3. They're basically the same thing. Apple actually calls it audioOS. Now this came in at 678.3 megabytes. That's on the iPhone 14 Pro Max. It was about 500 megabytes or so on the iPhone 11 and different devices here when I checked for an update. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and we'll talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings and under general and about, you can see the build number is 20C5049E. Apple is sticking with the E at the end of the build number. Typically this will get closer and closer to the letter A as we get closer to a final release. So it's a little odd that they're doing that. Now in this update, there is a modem update. If you're on any of the devices, I've heard from many of you that there's actually modem updates with Beta 3. If you're on a 14 Pro or Pro Max, you went from version 1.21.05 with Beta 2 to 1.22.00 with Beta 3. And so that should help with overall connectivity. It was a big improvement from Beta 1 to Beta 2. Hopefully it's even bigger from Beta 2 to Beta 3. Now, as far as what's new, well, there's quite a few new things to mention in this update. The first thing has to do with the always-on display. The always-on display, up until now, you could customize it with a sleep mode to turn off the wallpaper. Now there's a new option for that. So if we go into our settings, and within our settings, we go down to display and brightness, scroll down, you'll see always-on display. If you tap on this, this was just a little box or a little option before, and now we can turn on and off the always on display. We can show the wallpaper or not show the wallpaper, and the same is true for notifications. So if I turn off show wallpaper, turn off the display, now it's just a black display with the time, your widgets, and the date and weather, whatever you've got going on there. Also, you can turn off notifications the same way. So again, if we turn that off, we have nothing but just the time and the date, or if you don't have any widgets at all, you won't have anything there. So it's great that we now have this option. If you want the wallpaper and notifications on, you can leave them on. Now within shortcuts, there's a new shortcut, or they've made a change to one. And if we go into shortcuts, you have a new get battery status. Now, if we take a look at what we had with Beta 2, go under shortcuts here, you'll see that we had get battery level. They've updated this where it says it returns information about the battery and any charger connected to the device. And then the result, a number with the current battery percentage or a yes, no Boolean value. And the note says you can use this action to obtain the current battery percentage or to know whether your device is plugged into a charger or is charging. So that's been updated with shortcuts. So it's great to have that. Now I did a separate video today on Apple releasing the satellite connectivity feature, emergency SOS via satellite. Now this is available to everyone, but you can see now it says get help during an emergency. That's under your settings. If we go into that, you can learn more about it. It will load and say how you can get help during an emergency. Tap continue and it will connect to a satellite. I did a demo of this in a separate video and you can see that there, but if you want to check it out yourself, all you need to do, you need to be on iOS 16.1 or newer and be in the USA or Canada. It's available in other countries later in December, and then Apple hasn't said when they're rolling it out around the world. Now, if we go down to emergency SOS, scroll to the bottom, you can now try this out. It says iPhone can help start a satellite connection to contact emergency services when a call won't go through. Now you will need to have an iPhone 14 to see any of this, 14, 14 Plus, 14 Pro, or 14 Pro Max. So that's available now. Now there is more in iOS 16.2 Beta 3, and that has to do with Safari. If we go into Safari and you have private relay enabled under your iCloud settings. So within your settings, to see that you need to go to your account at the top under iCloud. If you have iCloud Plus, you'll have private relay. If that's enabled, you'll have these new features. So if we go into Safari, tap on the little options for a website, you'll see it says show IP address. Before this, it actually had a different message there. So I can show you that here where it actually said turn off hide IP address. So that's what it said before, and we have a new little icon that they've added for that. So again, you can see the icon. If we show IP address, it's going to ask us if we want to temporarily allow them to see my IP address. If we tap on continue, go back into that option, we now have the option to hide IP address, again with a new icon there. So it's a small update, but something that they've changed in this update. There's also a new option in accessibility. So within accessibility, if we go to accessibility, scroll down until we get to Siri. Under Siri, we have a new option for prefer silent responses. And you'll see here when that's checked, it says Siri will respond silently, except when you appear to be driving or using headphones with the screen off. If we go to beta 2, I didn't see it there. So again, if we go to accessibility and then down to Siri, we don't have the option. Instead, we just had under spoken responses, automatic, and prefer spoken responses. Now we have prefer silent responses. So it's a small update there. Now, if we go back and we go down to TV, under TV, if you're using live activities, they haven't updated the options here, but what they have updated is when you are following a sports game that's live, they've updated some things that it can tell you about that. So for example, when the game is suspended, you can get a notification about the suspension of the game. Also, if stats aren't available, it will allow you to know that. And if we go into the TV app, scroll down until we see sports, under sports, go to live sports, and you can see different sports you can follow. If we just tap the first one here that's live, it gives the current score, and then of course you can add it to up next, share it, or open it in something that you have a subscription to. If you're following this, it will be on the lock screen live and give you more information. So it's great to see more and more added to this. Of course, third-party apps can do this as well. Hopefully we see more from those in the future. Now, as someone who's made videos and tested iPhone OS and iOS for many, many years, Apple has provided a way to provide feedback to them if there's issues. I've always said, give them feedback. They'll take the most important issues and then fix that. However, quite a few issues seem to slip through despite us having millions of people testing it. And in a memo that was found on Mac Rumors today, Craig Federighi admitted that Apple's beta program doesn't provide the interaction and influence many users desire. This was mentioned by someone that's a Mac Rumors reader in a response to him, saying that they need a better way to do this. So we could see this updated with iOS 17, maybe a new feedback app or some different way for that to be given back to Apple and say, these are the most pressing issues. It may be something they need to fix on their end, or it could be just an all new app or a different way of doing the beta program in general. But either way, some odd issues do seem to slip through for some reason. So it's great to see them hopefully addressing that in the future. Now, as far as bugs in this update, well, there seems to be a fix for the lag scrolling. So with swiping home, I haven't seen that again, where if maybe we're playing music, we'll hit play, swipe it into the dynamic island. It's nice and fast. And you'll see there, the animation seems to be a little bit different as well. So that's something, it seems like it might stop a little bit and then go up into the dynamic island. So it is something that they continue to improve, and the overall lag scrolling slowdown seems to be fixed in this one. So that swipe home stutter bug, scrolling is fast in ProMotion, and cellular hopefully is improved with this. Now let's take a look at the release notes for this update. So we'll go into feedback, wait for it to load here within our recent activity or inbox. Of course, we have the new HomePod OS updates as well, 16.2, although Apple actually calls it Audio OS internally. We'll go here, wait for it to load, and you'll see with the latest beta 3 release notes, they've got some known issues still that they've fixed for Freeform, where it says they can't delete boards while offline, or if iCloud data is disabled for Freeform. They fixed adding or removing collaborators, where it would fail sometimes. They've also resolved an issue in health. They've resolved issues with HealthKit, and there's still some known issues with Stage Manager. That still seems to be very buggy when you're using an external display. So they say while using Stage Manager with an external display, dragging a second window to the workspace incorrectly hides the recent apps list. That was something they added with Beta 2, an updated feature where you could hide the recent apps or the dock or toolbar at the bottom. That wasn't even working properly. There's still some issues with that. Hopefully they resolve those soon. Now, as far as overall battery life, it will take a few days to measure that accurately. I'll have a follow-up on the weekend like I normally do, going over that in more detail, but we can take a quick look at what we have now. My battery health is at 100%, and that's pretty typical of a newer device. 2 years later, maybe 80% is normal, according to Apple. The last 10 days, you'll see yesterday I had 2 hours and 7 minutes of screen active time, and for some reason, 12 hours and 12 minutes of screen idle time. You'll see I used about 30% of my battery. Today, 3 hours and 6 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 24 minutes of screen idle time. So I continue to look into what the home screen and lock screen is doing. I do use always on display. I'll probably turn off the wallpaper to help try and improve that and see if it improves even more. Now, as I mentioned before, performance is nice and fast. ProMotion is nice and smooth. Going into different apps seems to be very fast. And many people so far, at least on my Telegram channel and Discord, report that it's actually nice and smooth this time around. So those are linked in the description if you want to check it out, but everything seems to be really smooth with this update. And as far as the phone getting hot, well, it's nice and cool overall. I've really had no issues with this, and let me show you quickly with the thermal camera. Now, as we use the thermal camera and bring it over the hottest part of the iPhone at about 84 degrees, that's about 28.7 degrees Celsius. So it's staying pretty cool, and it actually only heated up as I put it face down. It heated up a little bit. As you can see, I held the phone in my hand, and it's obviously warmer than the phone itself. So it seems to be performing quite well as far as overall temperature, no issues there. And as far as benchmarks, I did want to share that, and then we'll talk about when to expect the final release. So if we go into Geekbench, I ran it quickly right after installing the update, and I had 1,878 for single core, 5,398 for multi-core. Again, these are not really what you should expect as far as performance being much better or much worse using this, but as you can see, it's a little bit higher for single core by 1 point and a little bit higher for multi-core by about 91 or so points. So it's definitely better, but this isn't really going to show you that it's much, much better unless it's hundreds and hundreds more. But it seems to be nice and smooth and fast, like I mentioned before. Now, as far as the overall release of iOS 16.2, well, iOS 16.2 probably will release sometime in the middle of December, or maybe the second week. Last year, Apple released iOS 15.2 on December 13th, so the second week or third week of December seems to be most likely. Now, as far as the next beta, I would expect the next beta as soon as next week, maybe on the 22nd of November, with maybe a couple more than a release candidate and a final release in December, like I said. And so then we'll see iOS 16.3 betas probably sometime in January, like we did last year with iOS 15.3. That's typically what Apple does every year. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 16.2 beta 3? Well, if you have an extra device laying around and you don't need to use it full time, go ahead, make sure you have a backup. If you're already on iOS 16.2 beta 1 or beta 2, I would definitely install it, provide feedback as needed, depending on your overall experience. Otherwise, I usually tell people to hold off as far as betas go until they're released to the public so that we can figure out what the issue is. I don't normally recommend you run it on your main device. As far as iPadOS, well, there doesn't seem to be much different. Of course, if I find anything else, I'll be sure to mention it in a follow-up later this weekend or later this week, like I normally do. And let me know if you want to see that inside or outside, if possible, depending on weather, of course. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.